A huge and fascinating diversity of sea slugs, or opisthobranchs, are found in the Lembeh Strait. Opisthobranch means gills behind, because their gills are located behind their heart. Most have all but lost their protective shell, but compensate with more advanced weapons of defence. Over 6,000 different species of sea slug are nudibranchs. The name means naked gills, referring to the rosette of branchial plumes on their back surrounding their anus. These gills vary greatly in form, but all have a large surface area for oxygen exchange. The black margin Dory prismatica sometimes actively wiggles its gills, perhaps to increase water flow across them, as does this closely related Glossodoris slug. Nudibranchs have no eyes, but the rhinophores on their head are sensitive to smell and taste, as well as touch, helping them navigate, find food, and locate mates. The fine structure gives a high surface area for maximum chemical detection. The pairing of rhinophores gives sea slugs some spatial awareness. They can detect the direction that smells are coming from by comparing the intensity on each rhinophore. Most nudibranchs encountered in the Lembeh Strait are cryptobranchs, which means hidden gills. This is because they are able to retract their gills to protect them. Most species, such as this funeral Gerona slug, are also able to retract their rhinophores when under threat. This bowhull Discodoris nudibranch mimics a toxic polyclad flatworm. But it can also shed sections of its mantle if disturbed, a phenomenon known as autotomy. Most nudibranchs are toxic or distasteful, and many bear a dazzling array of flamboyant colours and patterns, one reason why they are so popular with divers. Some are even fluorescent. This is another example of aposomatic coloration, a warning to potential predators of their toxicity. Many nudibranchs of the Chromodoris genus bear similar black, longitudinal lines. Some suggest that their coloration has converged in an evolutionary phenomenon known as Mullerian mimicry. Predators that learn their lesson to not eat one species are likely to avoid all similarly patterned slugs. Alternatively, they may have simply diversified from a common ancestor. The truth may be a mixture of the two. The Ceratosoma genus, with its distinctive lobed body, is well represented in the strait. The raised horn behind the gills contains noxious chemicals from the sponges it feeds on. It is a sacrificial defensive lure, inviting predators to feed on it first, while the more important and less toxic part of the slug is preserved. Under attack, the gills would be withdrawn for protection. Often these toxic appendages do appear to be small and in the process of regeneration, suggesting previous attacks. Lone Bangai cardinal fish sometimes appear to form a symbiotic relationship with these nudibranchs. Perhaps they benefit from the shelter of a notoriously toxic companion. This slug has completely withdrawn its head and rhinophores, revealing its mouth. The gills of phyllidied nudibranchs are along their sides, hidden under the mantle rather than on their backs. When disturbed, they secrete a highly pungent poison from the tubercles on their body. This oscillate phyllidia bears false eye spots to give the illusion of a larger animal. The cardinal Philidiopsis differs greatly in colour and form from other Philidids. Its camouflage and reluctance to venture into the open during daylight suggests it might not be so toxic. Eolid nudibranchs have serrata along their backs rather than a plume of gills. They feed on stinging animals such as hydroids. They are immune to the hydroid stinging nematocysts, which are transported to the tips of the serrata, where they act as a defense. This nudibranch, commonly known as a blue dragon nudibranch, stores and cultivates zooxanthellae from one of its food sources. This is the same type of single-celled alga, a plant that lives symbiotically within reef-building corals. Inside the slug's body, the zooxanthellae continue to photosynthesize the sun's energy into sugars and other nutrients that the slug then metabolizes. In effect, the slug is solar-powered and can survive for lengthy periods on this fuel without feeding. The plants benefit from the arrangement too, as they are protected and can flourish inside the nudibranch's body. The serrata have evolved to give maximum exposure to sunlight. Patches of brown show where clusters of zooxanthellae are stored, and the white areas show where it is lacking. This nudibranch of the Philodesmium genus has a magnificent shrimp for company. These slugs are also solar-powered. They obtain their symbiotic zooxanthellae from their prey of Xenia's soft corals. Although they can secrete repellent substances from their serrata, they don't store stinging nematocysts like most other eolids. They compensate for this with camouflage by mimicking the soft corals that they feed on. They also readily shed their serrata if disturbed. Most sea slugs have a ribbon-like tongue covered in microscopic teeth called a radula to help them consume their prey.